We are creating a React app, the React MindMap app. We have done the layout. We have created icon buttons and toolbars. Now we need routing to change screens. We need three screens: home, map, and help screen. The home screen to show the list of mind maps. Yes, there could be more than one mind map. The map screen is the core of the app. This screen is to view, to edit, and to create mind map items. And last but not least, the help screen, because there's no app without help. Each screen is a React function component. Now we need to list all acceptable routes. Each route has a name, a component, and breadcrumbs. The name is used in the URL. The component is used to render the screen content. And the breadcrumbs are used for navigation. So we have three routes for three screens. The main part is the route object. The object to keep methods. The method to set a route. The method to get a route. And the method to get the route params. And the list of handlers that must be executed when the route is changed. The init method is executed on app start. This method defines the list of acceptable routes and defines a handler for browser back and forward buttons. The setRoute method changes the URL in the browser. We need to push URL in the window history object to use back and forward browser buttons. The getRoute and the getRoute params methods are just getters. The set method extracts the route name and the params from the window location path name and select the current route from the route list. The onChange method executes one by one all the handlers that has been added by the subscribe method. So what do we have to do if the route changes? We need to replace the content of the app. First of all, we need to convert the function component to the class component, because we need to keep track of what the content we are demonstrating. We need the state object to keep track. So let's change the function to a class that extends the React component. We need to add the constructor. The constructor is executed before the component is rendered. So in the app component constructor, we can init the router. In the constructor, we can set the initial state with the initial root. When the root is changed, we get the current root from the router and change the content of component. That's all. We almost done. Just set the left menu actions. And the breadcrumbs. That's good. Now we have different screens in the same layout, and we can change the screens by clicking on the icon button toolbar. But we still have no data to show in the app. We create the data repository in the next video. Thank you for watching to the end. Subscribe to our channel and you will learn how to add the data repository.